We are live from Atlanta, Georgia's Dirty South Dome. And I noticed they've cleaned this place up a bit.
Yeah, I remember finding a lot more severed fingers in my chili last time. And there were fewer bodies to step over in the men's room. Place is kind of losing its character.
I miss the shit sandwiches.
Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this NFL matchup. The New Orleans Zombies battle the Atlanta Vultures. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's game day here on the NFL Network, and we are just about to get underway. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
Any thoughts on today's game?
Not really. Kind of flatlining right now in the thoughts department. Hey, can you help me get this pencil out of my ear? It's stuck worse than it was the last time.
Yeah, you idiot. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
Second down and a lot.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Hot one. Hot two, three.
Caught for the first down. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Second down in a mile.
Hey, Mouse, here comes Kettle now. You know what?
Third down in forever. They pick up a nice chunk of yards on that pass play. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. Oh, no good. Now that punter's gonna fight. He just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's first and ten. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. And then he jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. And it's first and ten. Dirt sandwich. And it's first and ten. And they pick up nine with that catch.
Not enough for first, but still nice game.
And that'll bring up second and one. Quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver, and he burst into the end zone for the score! What a run!
Is that right, Quinn? That penalty makes no sense!
As extra mayo. Second down and one. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down and ain't going to happen, partner. Giving the quarterback many passing lanes to hit a receiver. Nice block by the defense there. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Should move him back nicely. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Nice pickup for 6 yards. That'll be second down and 4.
It's a touchdown!
I've never seen a demon smile so much. He says his secret is that he's poisoned the minds of 1,000 men. That never works, I guess. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sits up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10.
I ate a piece of licorice once and got a shot like that.
It wasn't licorice, you idiot. It was the frayed cords of the leaf blower.
Well, it was a red cord and it looked like licorice. The point is... I forgot my point.
And it's first and 10.
Two.
A nice run there for 8 yards. Second down and 2. Warming up. And he held on to that one for a first down. Now, these penalties have really gotten out of hand, especially since they're fake.
Go to Dirty Tricks and hit attack ref. It feels good.
Third down, and the QB offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery.
This will be your guy, don't you?
Third down and forever.
Hot one.
And he was stuck to him like glue. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he's got a chance for a good return here. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
And it's first and ten.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and six. Man, what a hit that was. Third down and a pussy hair. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Scrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Hot one.
Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Third and two. First down. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
First down in a mile.
Not one.
And the defense gave up a lot of yards on that pass play. They'll need to regroup quickly. Second down in a very lot.
Hot one, hot two.
The receiver makes a grab for 5 yards. And that'll bring up third down and seven. Well, sometimes the best thing. having to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And the punter has one job to do, and that's punt the ball. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball is down.
And it's first and 10.
A lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And it's first and 10.
I've seen this guy run through a brick wall. He loves pain. First down.
And it's first and 10. Oh no, it's a sticky ball dirty trick. The defense pretty much turned the ball into a yo-yo of doom.
Did you ever think you'd say that, Grim? A yo-yo of doom?
No, my friend, I didn't. I love this job. Second down and a lot. With the brain scrambler. Third down and 3. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10. Stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners.
The kick is good.
As expected. Just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one.
The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Second down and long. The brutal hit. And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, the player on roid rage would win. And he's off to the races. They might catch him.
Move, you fat little mutant.
Touchdown! And he rumbles that one into the end zone. Nicely done!
I can't run like that unless it's coupon night at Taco Hell. He has better footwork though than me on account of not clenching and keystone.
Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. Time out to try and stay in this game.
Ah, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
Well, surprise me. He made it look easy and he gets 3 points for it. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? I'm going to go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down and just pet your rabbit, Lenny? Just pet your rabbit. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
Second down in a very lot. Oh, nice hit. And it's first and 10.
The chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. The defense better look out. The offense called the Beast Boost dirty trick. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not gonna dance now.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10.
two.
That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Third down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Oh, with a punishing hit. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. He's got the ball now. Ooh, that hit's going to shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Oh, mama. He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second and 3. Unfortunate. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. Something going here. And it's first and 10. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Bricks' mom decided to move back in with us.
Second down and 2. Third down and, well, good luck. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws a supersonic missile to his receiver.
Hey, watch it! Junior, you just spilled your scotch all over my shoulder!
I didn't know if the shockwave spilled my drink.
This is going to be a long kick. Let's see if he can make it. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just give him the points and let's move on.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
Yes.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's first and 10.
Hey.
that's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. And these guys think kicking is for pussies, Bricks. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Yeah, bigger than you.
And they run it in for 2 points. Well, it's all fun and games until he tries breakdancing.
Yep, with skeletons, it's always more literal.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Boom! And it's first and 10. And he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 9. With a brutal hit. And it's first and 10. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Listen to his fans howl. They love him. He came up with a teenage werewolf in the Mutant Farm League.
I don't know if he's dancing or just marking his territory.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
The roid rage dirty trick transforms a player into a rampaging lunatic for the duration of the play. I know that he dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
Hmm. 10-yard pickup there. Normally a first down, but here, he's just making up ground.
Commish makes up news.
Third down and a sliver.
Hot one, hot two, hot
three. Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut and you'll tire these guys out. First down. And it's first and 10.
First down.
I see this guy drop a lot. in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
First down! Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take.
And this ref is definitely on the take. That was a bogus penalty. First down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever.
Hot one, hot two.
Pick six, but dropped the interception.
And it plays on defense, schmuck.
Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this.
Hot one.
Quarterback brings the explode, and the defensive player got blown to bits. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle.
Hot one,
the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick, and the quarterback is in a shitload of trouble.
He's trying to throw the ball, Grim, but it keeps coming back to him.
This one just in some fun of your time.
Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he put all of his foot into that one. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He tackled with the frame scrambler. And punter was killed, so now they'll need to find another player on the bench to punt from here on out.
Yeah, who gives a crap about punters anyway?
Punters' moms? Wives? Kids?
First and 10.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Let me tell you, getting shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wool socks, slide around on a shag carpet for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel, he got blown across the room into the deer antlers.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And he breaks through for a touchdown! Listen to this crowd! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Was a bone crusher right there, folks. The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry up too?
Grim, can I kill him?
Ah. Second down, and the offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the two-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Four yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock-blocked the clock.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense.
One, hot two.
And that is caught for a first down. And that's it. That's the last timeout. It's score or die from here out. And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. Well, that should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick.
I thought they were going to do some sort of chorus line.
Is how you recover an onside kick. And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
Eh, big deal. Missed a meet for Braves ran with a ball, didn't fall down.
It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. They'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. One whole highlight. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And he catches it for a touchdown! What a beautiful play!
Yeah, it's almost poetic, Grim, like a haiku!
And here comes the extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
We're deadlocked with a tie score at the end of the fourth, and that can mean only one thing. Stay tuned, because what the hell could be more important right now?
Well, now that you mention it, Grim, I really need to hit the can.
Breaks overtime is a war with some basic rules. The first touchdown wins the game, but if the team that receives the kickoff gets a field goal, then the other team is allowed a possession too. After that, whomever scores wins.
Grandma, I didn't understand any of that. Can you repeat it?
Not a chance. For 5 yards. Second down and 5. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Drills one in for the first down. And it's 1st and 10.
Is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have him reattach my big toe to where my thumb was again. It just fell off for the 3rd time today. I was barely even chewing on it.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Vultures limp away defeated.
Yeah, they look so sad, Grim. I kind of feel sorry for them. They deserve a participation award.
Screw those boys.
They battled hard, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every up.